All right, 20 minutes after 8 o'clock. Thank you for tuning in. I get starstruck, Robin, sometimes. Even if it's on the phone, I get starstruck. If there's somebody on the phone I'm going to talk to and I've been a fan forever, then I make an idiot out of myself. I listen to the recordings later on and I go, oh my gosh, listen to how dumb I was. Oh my gosh, I hope I'm not dumb this time. Try to keep the reins on me, would you?
Okay.
Oh, so when I was in elementary school, we had a French teacher, right? She taught us how to say bonjour, monsieur, bonjour, madame. But, you know, it wasn't until I heard this that I really learned the important words. You ready? Here we go. Oh my gosh, Patti Labelle is on the phone. Oh my gosh, Patti Labelle, do I need to say anything? She's a music legend.
No,
good morning.
Hi, Robin.
Oh,
hi, Larry. I'm here with my friend Liz.
And Liz Ward is there, yes. Liz is a registered dietitian. We got something serious to talk about with diabetes,
okay.
Right?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Yes, we do.
So good morning, Liz.
Good morning. I'm also starstruck.
Oh, are you in the same room with each other?
Oh yeah, I'm watching her.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Patti, I want to thank you for teaching me that French word, those French lines. That was so useful.
But Larry, when I recorded the song, I had no clue what that voulez-vous-touché meant until we had some interest from the nuns saying that those ladies should not be singing about hookers. I had no clue that it was a hit, you know. And I'm singing after 41 years. I sing it every night on my show.
Do you really? Oh my gosh!
Yeah.
Oh my God! You are such a legend. But you have some sad news too. You have a lot of family members that were affected by diabetes, mm-hmm. right?
Yes, my mother, my uncle, my aunt, blindness, amputations, my mother's legs.
Oh my gosh!
My uncle's eyes also, and they just left. And I was diagnosed over 20 years ago. And when I fell out on stage, I passed out on stage, so I thought it was because we had been touring so much that I was just tired. And the doctor came back with my diagnosis and said, you're a diabetic. I said, are you serious? And so I knew I had to cut out that fried chicken and all of that other stuff, all the pizza with the extra cheese and all that good stuff. And, you know, my macaroni and cheese, I had to let it go.
Oh, but, man, really?
I had to start exercising a lot and... But the things that saved me, I mean, some of the things that saved me is the hood calorie countdown beverage, because with my macaroni and cheese, I do it with the less calorie cheese and with the beverage. You know, it's better than milk for me, and it tastes great, and I learned to live with this diabetes because I'm cursed.
So do you know how to handle it. So do you monitor it regularly? Like, do you take your blood readings and all that? Yeah.
You have to take your blood sugar 3 times a day, and I'm taking some sorts of insulin. You know, my A1C has gone down a lot from when I was diagnosed. First, it was 11 point something, and now I'm in the lower sevens. You know, and I'm doing well with it.
See, I don't even know what those numbers mean, but that sounds good, right? That's a good number.
Liz can tell you what they mean.
Those are very good numbers. Very good numbers.
Uh-huh.
Two thumbs up from me.
So should we all be taking our blood reading, or only if a doctor says we have been diagnosed with diabetes?
If they think that you might be a candidate for diabetes, they're going to have you take your blood sugar. And, you know, a lot of my friends, I had an extra kid at home, and I would do their sugar. I said, girlfriend, you can't really be a diabetic. So it's good to check yourself. You know, if you have the means to check yourself, it's not going to hurt.
Is it an American thing? Like, is it our lifestyle? Do people like in Asia, do they get diabetes? Or am I generalizing?
No, of course. People get diabetes all over the world. But every year, 1.5 million Americans are diagnosed with diabetes. And a lot of it can be prevented through lifestyle. Patti was talking about checking one of your child's blood sugar levels. There's a condition called prediabetes that we want to be aware of as well. And it's telling you, that's a red flag, you're on track to develop type 2 diabetes. But as long as you're... you know, eating a balanced diet that's right for you, after seeing a registered dietitian, which I always think is a good idea, you can really reverse the symptoms of type 2 diabetes and prevent a lot of health problems.
Does walking help? I've heard that, and I'm just throwing it out there because I've heard it, but I don't know that I got it from a reliable source.
Absolutely.
Yeah, exercise helps.
Do you walk?
You know, any exercise can help. I can't swim. but I get in my short end of the pool and I kick, you know, and I do things that I can do. We can all walk the dog or walk ourselves.
Yeah.
You know what? Any physical activity reduces your blood glucose level to normal levels. So it's great to move around. Part of our problem is that we're too sedentary. Mm-hmm. So you don't have to do anything elaborate. You just put your walking shoes on and you get out mm-hmm. and walk. And it could be at 10, 20 minute blocks at a time during the day.
Patti is so active on stage. I'm trying to figure this out. It looks like she's doing a workout.
But guess what, Larry? Because I've been in this business for 54 years, I've learned on stage when I get on the floor and I roll around on the stage, people thought I was crazy. But I enjoy rolling and kicking off my shoes and just having fun. And that is one great way for me to exercise on stage. I love it.
Oh, my gosh.
Exercise can be fun. It doesn't mm-hmm. have to be a drag.
I'm going to start rolling around, Robin.
You better be able to get
I'd like to see that. Take a video.
No, you don't want to see that.
Well, right now the holidays are coming up, and I love to eat. And what kind of advice do you give so you don't feel like you're not part of a holiday setting?
I would say have the holiday meal that you've always had in your family. I'm not going to change that. I'm going to cook everything for the family, the things that they love. But I have a little side patty plate. You know, I'll make mine with less everything. And have fun and watch them enjoy that good old food that might give you diabetes. And I'll try not to give them that, but they all want it. You know?
Yeah, mac and cheese.
You can make substitutions, right, at the holidays if you use...
like the macaroni.
Yeah, like the macaroni and cheese that Patti was talking about, but... Quick Calorie Countdown is a great milk substitute mm-hmm. as well as a cream substitute.
Yes.
So you can really cut back on the carbohydrate, calories, and the sugar when you use that.
So you've mentioned that a couple times now. What is that? Hood Calorie Countdown.
Right. So it's a creamy, delicious dairy beverage, and it has fewer calories, less sugar, and fewer carbohydrates than regular milk. And it's great to use in your coffee. You can use it in your cereal.
Really?
In cooking, or just drink a glass of it on its own.
All right. So I'm going to use that. I'm going to roll around. What else? I need to walk more. Give up the mac and cheese.
Trust me, it works. It does work.
Well, you sound good, Patti. I'm glad you're in good
health. Thank you,
Larry. It's such an honor to have you on the show.
And
Thank you,
Patti, you really have gone really fast forward with this because you have so many books out there, and you also focus on the cooking, and you have things like sweet potato pie and cakes.
Yes, I have a no sugar added sweet potato pie now, and I'm going to do more no sugar added items because people love the sweet potato pies and the peach cobblers, so I'm going to make it healthier for some people.
And we have some great recipes at HoodCalorieCountdown.com,
Okay. HoodCalorieCountdown.com, PattiLabelle.com. Liz, thank you for what you're doing. You're making the world a better place. Patti, I got to tell you something. Thank you for what you've done. There's something about the connection you had with me and probably every one of your fans that really, we owe you a big thank you. You know?
You're amazing.
Thank you so much, Larry and Robin, for feeling that way.
Oh, my gosh.
I do this for a reason, and I hope I can touch more people.
I often think entertainers don't realize what they give, and you have given us so much.
Well, I'm going to continue, Larry.
I hope
so.
Thank you so much, Robin. Thank you both. Thank you for being on the show with us today.
Thank you.
Okay. Hope to meet you one day, Larry.
I'm going to be rolling around. I'll send you a video of me rolling around on the floor.
I can't wait.
All right. Thank you. We'll be right back.
Thank you.